Hi, this is Graham. Hope everyone's having a great day. Wherever you go now, you'll find that people are taking more and more photographs using smartphones than are probably using compact digital cameras. Have we reached the stage in technology where the camera technology has improved to such a degree that we can rely on smartphones to give us reasonable image quality for both stills and video content? Or is it that we've dumbed ourselves down into accepting a low quality from smartphones and they'll be sufficient for our needs? This came about because a couple of weeks ago I was out and I didn't take my compact digital camera with me because it was raining, and I came across a situation where I wanted to take some video. I had my Apple iPhone 4S, so I shot the video with that, and the results were quite acceptable. Even blown up onto a 42-inch plasma TV, the results were quite good. So then I started to think, well, have we reached this stage in technology where it would be more convenient to carry just a smartphone than carrying my phone and a compact digital camera? With the new breed of cameras, such as this Nokia Lumia 925, we've got an f2.0 lens and we've got optical image stabilisation. So theoretically, we've got a convenient machine here to deliver the goods. And also with the Sony Xperia Z, we have Sony's proven camera technology built into the phone system. So I've done some tests with the Lumia 925 and with the Xperia Z just to convince myself whether this technology is at a stage where perhaps I can leave aside the compact digital camera when I'm out and about for casual snaps. The Lumia 925 supports an f2.0 lens and has optical image stabilization, so it should give me some decent HD video. It also has a 8 megapixel sensor, which does give you the opportunity of doing some slight digital zoom for HD video. Wouldn't use the digital zoom in stills because you'll get pixelization, but because of the format of the HD video, you can actually use a couple of times digital zoom and get away with it. With the Sony Xperia Z, there's no optical image stabilization, so unfortunately, with these cameras being low mass, you do tend to exaggerate any handshake with the camera, and that shows itself up on video. Obviously, you could stabilize the camera by using a gorilla pod or a tripod, but that gets away from the spontaneous nature of having a device where you can capture video straight out of your pocket. The image quality from the Xperia Z is superb. The still image quality is very nice, a lot more camera control in terms of exposure value compensation, white balance adjustment and ISO adjustment than you have over the 925 with the current camera apps that are available. The 925 has a nice video mode and you've got the facility to do manual focus pulls, but unfortunately the white balance control and the exposure determination are a little bit weak on the 925, and you'll notice from the test footage you'll see quite a bit of white balance shift and brightness shift as I move the camera around. So until the developers can actually get a camera application which will lock down exposure value compensation and lock down white balance in the auto mode a little bit better, then this camera lacks in performance. If we add optical image stabilization on the Xperia Z, this would be a superb smartphone. Maybe with the Z1 that's due to be announced shortly, we will have optical image stabilization and that will make it a superb smartphone. As more and more people are using these smartphones to take their pictures for upload onto social network sites such as Facebook or Instagram, then I think the camera manufacturers will actually up their game with the quality of the images from their devices. But now the Xperia Z does give you some superb images, and indeed the 925, if you tame it, will give you some superb images as well. So here are the test results from both of the cameras, and indeed that test footage I did with the Apple iPhone 4. Stills, this is a beautiful camera, and I've got some really good results from this camera. Plenty of depth of field, even though it's only an f2.0 lens, because of the size of the sensor. It's a fixed aperture camera. The exposure is determined by the ISO and by the shutter speed. So if you are shooting video in bright sunshine, you'll notice that you get a lot of staccato effects because the shutter speed could have gone up to a 2,000th of a second to control the exposure. If it was possible, we could actually put ND filters over the front of the camera, and that would bring the shutter speed back down to a realistic value. But apart from making some sort of rig to hold neutral density in the front of there, it's not possible directly with the camera, nor is it possible with the Nokia camera either. There's no facility to add neutral density within the camera. So for social networking, uploading videos to YouTube, just viewing the videos on the back of the camera on these 4-inch screens, the results are quite pleasing, even in the video mode. You don't see that much handshake. But put these into a large format TV, you will notice that handshake, and that is a detraction from the quality of the video. So that's my mini review of the performance of these two new cameras in the smartphone market. So hopefully that's convinced you that we can use these in the stills mode, and if we can improve the stabilisation of the Xperia Z, then we'll have a superb video camera as well. So until my next video, thanks very much for watching, and of course if you don't already subscribe to my channel, please consider doing so. So until the next video, thanks very much for watching. Graham saying take care, and bye for now.